Cece. Nice to meet you. I'll be your makeup artist today. I understand we're going to go through a trial for your wedding makeup. Yeah. Excellent, if you'd just like to take a seat. I'll just start with removing. You haven't got much makeup on, but I'll just remove what you have got. These ones are fragrance free, and they've been dermatologically tested and paediatrician approved. They're very nice. They smell, they're fragrance free, but they smell really clean. Do now is just use this stuff. It's to remove like any oils. You haven't got very oily skin, but sometimes these can leave like little oils behind, so I'm just gonna use this. I like this range. It's each different one has like a nice smell. I'm gonna put a little bit of moisturiser on your face just as a base so the makeup goes on nice and easy. And this is gonna be Olay Total Effects. It says age defying, but you don't need that. I'm just gonna cheeks. I'm gonna start with the makeup. Do you usually wear foundation? Do before we actually get onto anything, I'm just gonna put a nice base on. So I'm gonna use some concealer to cover the just the little red marks, and then I'm gonna put some liquid concealer on, then some foundation, and finish off some powder. I'm just going to use some of this Match Perfection in Ivory. It actually looks like your colour. You've got very pale colour, like myself. And this is a 2-in-1 concealer and highlighter. Okay. Squeeze it around. one's one of my favourites. For me. See which colour matches you best. When's your wedding? Not long then. You got everything sorted? I guess everyone asks you that. Sounds amazing. Okay, I'm just gonna finish this off with a little bit of blusher. I say blusher, I meant bronzer. I wondered why you were looking at me funny. I'm putting blusher on your head. Bronzer. So ditzy. So what are your favours? Wow, that's cool. What happens if somebody wins? Do you think they would? Trying to see what kind of blush you want. I've got a couple here. Let's see if I've got any more. I've got this one. It's the liquid one. And it's like a red. Well, it's a cherry. This one, there's not much left, but this is like a deep pink, but when it goes on very natural. So what that looks like, I'll just put that on there. Put this one on. So you can see the colour difference of those two. Obviously, the blusher won't be that dark, but it's just because I've left it on my skin. So it'll be a very pale version of those two, or you can have like a dusky pink. Okay. Mm-hmm. This is the popular one. Okay, now eyes. Have you thought about what you'd like? Would you like something natural like mine? More natural. Okay. Bourgeois one. What about that? Not too dark. Okay. How about this one? It's called Ivy Leaf. Still too dark. It's got a lovely shimmer to it. No? Okay. No. How about that one? And maybe we'll try that. And then that on the crease. Oh, that one. Lovely. Tease in the middle. Missing something. I think we'll try. I've got a pink shimmer here. I've got two pinks. There's that one there. This one. I'm going to try this one to highlight. I think that one's just a little bit too glitzy. Get a brush. Right. This just gets dabbed on your brow. Just there, and it just highlights it. decide on which colour you are. I think you're more Can use this to comb through. I'm just gonna try a little bit of eyeliner on you. We've got three different eyeliners here. One is like a cream eyeliner. The texture's just a little bit like lipstick. We've got a felt tip eyeliner and a liquid one. I'll show you them. This is the liquid one. You can sort of do whatever you want with that, really. This is the creamy one. This is also a waterproof. And then this one is the felt tip. You've got the felt tip, the waterproof cream one, and the liquid eyeliner. Okay, I'll just use some, get this off my hand. I once forgot to take this off my hand and I ended up rubbing it all over somebody's face. It's so funny. But I wouldn't do that today. A really good one. You can have as much or as little as you want, and then the end, this is cool, as a smudger, you can smudge it in. Okay, look up for me. A little bit of a wing tip on the top with the felt tip one. Okay. some mascara on. Oh. I always forget this part. Curl your lashes before the mascara. And last but not least, your lips. I've got here three different types of lip covering. I've got two glosses, and this one is like a lip tint. It's if you're not used to wearing gloss, sometimes you can put a gloss on and your hair sticks to it. I've actually got fourth one. I knew I had some nails. I have got a lip stick. So this one. So you can see very, very faint. It's just a natural tint. And then there's like a balm. But it's a shiny balm. So it kind of acts as like a gloss, but your hair doesn't stick to it. That's a really nice one. This lipstick is by Revlon and it's called Pink Pout. This one is by Urban Decay. This one cools and plumps. Squeezy. As you can see, it is kind of sticky. Oops. But it smells of mint. And then this last one, this one is called Whisper, and it's by Number 7. So, if you take a look at those, we've got the Urban Decay one that cools and plumps, we've got Pink Pout from the lipstick, Whisper from Number 7, and we've got the lip tint. We can try that, yeah? It does after a while. Sometimes all I'm doing is wiping makeup off my hand. Okay, so we're gonna go with the lipstick. And just open your mouth. How do you feel? You want to look in the mirror? Yeah. So do you like how it's highlighted? Okay, yeah, we can do that next time. Okay, that's fantastic. I'm glad you enjoyed it.